A lot has been said about meditation and mindfulness. My aim here is to make it simple. Broadly, the two methods of meditation. Meditation in which you focus your attention on any internal or external object, known as concentration meditation. The object of focus may be your breath, a mantra, a part of body or any other object. The second method is in which you do not focus your attention on anything, known as awareness meditation. In this, you keep your attention open and monitor all aspects of your experience in the present, without making any judgment or attachment. What is the difference between meditation and mindfulness? Meditation in the West was considered more as an Eastern practice, patronized by sages and monks. To make it acceptable and popular to the general populace of the West, it was termed as mindfulness, an exercise in awareness, which means the same thing as meditation. There is practically no difference between the two. With my 15 years of experience, I have realized meditation is all about keeping your body and mind still. Your mind always wanders, either in the past or in the future. The aim is to control and tame your mind, to remain in the present and be aware, be mindful of what is happening in the present. Meditation has numerous benefits. I'll speak from my experience. I used to be very restless and short-tempered. With meditation, I became calm and could exercise a good control over my anger. I had difficulty in sleeping. Now I'm able to sleep within 20 minutes of hitting the bed. My blood pressure used to be on the higher side. It became normal and close to ideal. I frequently used to feel stressed and under pressure of work. It has helped me improve my focus and ability to work under stress. I had difficulty in maintaining good interpersonal relationships. My interpersonal relationships have improved with all. I found an improvement in my mood, a feeling of happiness and general well-being. It has helped me increase my intuitive powers and creativity. It has brought about true personal transformation in me. Here are some tips for beginners. In the beginning, one has a problem of concentrating, which is a common complaint by all beginners. So be patient and don't get frustrated. With passage of time, your concentration will improve. You can choose any method, concentration method or awareness method of meditation, or a combination suiting you. You can even experiment and make a variation, so long as it helps you in achieving a state of tranquility. In meditation, we train our minds to focus in spite of distracting thoughts. As we do not attach any emotions or attention to these passing thoughts, our brain gets relieved and we can use the same strength and energy in our daily life. Timings are not very sacrosanct for meditation, but early mornings are considered preferable. Doing meditation in a group or with your partner is more effective and increases the benefits. There is no religion or faith attached to any form of meditation. The ideal posture for meditation is sitting in a cross-legged position without any movement, but you can assume any comfortable position so long as your back is upright. Doing meditation in lying down position is not recommended as a routine. However, you can do it as a variation once in a while, especially when you have difficulty in falling asleep. There is no age restriction for doing meditation. It is equally beneficial to youngsters as well as elders. The place for meditation really does not matter. Only make sure that the place is clean, airy, and free of distraction. The best thing about meditation is that it does not cost anything and can be done anywhere at any time. Meditation is an exercise for mind like physical exercise for body. A healthy mind ensures a healthy body too. The deep rest experienced in 10 minutes of meditation is far more useful and beneficial than the extra 30 minutes of sleep. Meditation can be integrated into a daily life routine. You can do it at other times like walking, waiting for the bus or train, waiting in traffic, etc. with your eyes open. With constant practice, you can be in meditative state at all the times. You may experience different sensations during the meditation process. there may be a feeling of twitching, tickling, shivering, sleepiness, energy current passing through, seeing visual patterns, etc. All these are considered normal. The emphasis of traditional meditation gurus was more on achieving peace of mind and higher spiritual growth. Health benefits were only considered by them as a byproduct. However, today, meditation is being advocated as means of achieving better health and physical healing. This is because the scientific research has proved beyond doubt that people who meditate have a better health and fewer physical problems. So, don't hesitate to try. You don't lose anything. Consider the time spent on meditation as an investment. You will reap the returns in the form of peace of mind, calmness, and improved energy levels. You may start small, with short sessions of 5 to 10 minutes each, once or twice a day. Try for at least 1 month in continuation. Experience the difference and then take a call.